Passage 6 to 24 starts off Juz 12 rebuking the disbeliever for his attitude towards the Quran and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. In his ignorance, he labels Quran a lie. Rebuking this attitude in verse 13 is a challenge to produce 10 surahs like it. The surah ends this discourse at verse 24, describing the disbeliever as deaf and blind. Next, the surah takes us back in history to give us examples of the previous messengers who experienced the same rejection as the Prophet himself. The discourse starts at 25 with Nuh alayhi salam, who just like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam was labeled a liar. Verse 27, whereas 50 onwards is the story of Hud alayhi salam, who also just like the Prophet was tied to his people through blood relations. Verse 50, وَإِلَىٰ عَادٍ أَخَاهُمْ. Verse 61 onwards is the story of Salih alayhi salam, who similar to the community of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, dealt with a group of people that matched Quraysh's false sense of pride. How could they separate from the ways of their forefathers? In verse 62. 69 to 75 is the story of Allah's mercy through Ibrahim alayhi salam and the angels who arrived to give him the good news of Ishaac alayhi salam. This is then followed by a powerful description of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's wrath as it unleashed on the disbelievers of Lut alayhi salam, the people of Shuaib alayhi salam, and then Firawn and his people, concluding this discourse in verse 99. In verses 100 to 125, closing Surah Hud are passages that warn the disbelievers amongst the Quraysh to take lessons from these past communities and at the same time advises the Prophet to remain firm in 112. Concluding with the message of submission to his will and his qada in verse 123. The final passage of Juz 12 is parts from the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, beginning with his dream of 11 stars as well as the sun and the moon all prostrating to him in verse 4. The remainder of the Juz until 52 talks about the three different trials that Yusuf alayhi salam had to endure, first as a young boy and then as a young man, before his good fortune as the minister of Egypt. The first trial, 7 to 21, his brothers scheming to get rid of him and then throwing him into the well. The second trial, 22 to 29, the trial of temptation, when his master's wife invited him shamelessly. The third and final trial, 30 to 53, when he is thrown into the prison even after his innocence is proven against the wicked scheming of his minister's wife and her fellow women. While in prison, he provides the true interpretation of the dreams of the baker and the butler. In this passage is also Yusuf alayhi salam's interpretation of the king's dream of the 7 lean cows and 7 fat ones, and the 7 green stalks of wheat next to 7 dried ones. The king, fascinated by his interpretation, arranges for Yusuf's release, but he, alayhi salam, refuses to leave until his innocence is established. It's only after the minister's wife admits to her evil schemes, Yusuf alayhi salam leaves the prison an honorable man. وحملته في فلكك المشحون يا من أحال النار حول خليله روحا وريحانا بقولك كون